Right, so we're going to go on and we're going to go on to episode 4 of Life is Strange. Oh, I haven't even listened to the ending, but...
Previously on Life is Strange.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now! It won't work!
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Coffey, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet! Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, alright? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files.
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
Listen, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than a friend.
I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield. Hold on. Chloe, you have a visitor.
Life is strange, it's based on a story that plays features, consequences, or whatever. Thing is, I already know this, and even with the stupid camera, you can still see them with their few sets. We haven't even got to the ending bit, I feel like crying in every scene. Oh, jeez. Thank God for the storms here. I know where we are. We're at the beach, we are. I don't think we're starting off at the beach so soon. Well, episode 1 we did, but apart from that, not the west. Sorry, no, I hate replaying all of this.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max.
So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
The worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how you feel. At least I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like the girl from Blackwell.
You mean Rachel Amber? When was the last time you talked to her?
Never. I just read about her in the news. I didn't even know her name. You did?
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
It might be, but I'd like to think we can still change things for the better.
I'd like to think that too. But I don't have much hope these days.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again.
Chloe doesn't know about Max's power.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
None taken.
Chloe's like an ultimate person in this one. In this world.
Oh, it's a pretty high-tech layer.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you are here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive. When you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science ball.
I can't even imagine.
but you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids. Thanks again for coming, Max. I need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water? Drink up, Buttercup. Oh man. No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year. Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult now. It seems like we were kids in another life.
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
Which friends did you hang out with the most?
Megan Weaver, but you don't know her. She was cool. But after my accident, she was too cool for school.
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
I know this is a dumb question, but are you lonely here?
Yes, dumb question. I don't mind being alone. I can't exactly go party like a rock star, though. Or get in any teen trouble with the folks.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can he pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Chloe, you're priceless. No pun intended.
You are such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I do. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Chris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair. Now let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when you watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now. That's a serious heat lamp. At least Chloe doesn't weigh that much. Oh man, she has to use that ventilator just to breathe. Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student. Gutless bastard. I'm so glad Chloe stole your bullshit fund. Even if it wasn't another reality. Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too.
Max's.
I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair. Chloe is still a punk at heart, but she can't stage dive anymore. That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
Okay, so where is all of this?
Here's the DVD.
Sleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep the swag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use her shitty tube television.
So I guess Nathan's the new one.
Through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same.
so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. And she's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed. But she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. You could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys financially.
His bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. The price is always right. Get it? No?
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question.
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pam Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber.
Oh, yeah, she went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
No change to spare anymore. Now it's back to cookies.